An update now to a Problem Solvers investigation we first told you about last week. A woman getting mail related to unemployment benefits for hundreds of other people. And it turns out she's not the only one with that problem. Our Melissa Hiplett has that update.
Not my name. Not my name at all.
Jacqueline Barber is fed up.
They need to get this straight.
We've shared her story twice. Since late last year, she has received hundreds of letters from the Virginia Employment Commission with her address on them, but not her name.
If this is a scheme, I don't know how they're doing it. I just need for this to end.
Since our story aired, we've heard from a number of people in Central Virginia who say this has happened to them too. Last week, VEC spokeswoman Joyce Fogg told us their fraud unit is investigating the situation. By the end of the week, she told our Bill Fitzgerald this is fraud.
Those are not people who have legitimate claims. Those are people who are trying to fraud the system, and they've put a name in that they've stolen the information with an address where they'll try to come by and pick up the mail before the person picks their mail up.
At first, Fogg declined to tell CBS 6 how many claims have been filed fraudulently, how much money may have been paid out on fraudulent claims, and how much of that money they've been able to recoup so far. She said it would require time staff needs to assist clients. So we submitted a Freedom of Information Act request on March 18th. On Friday, we received a response. Hours after the VEC sent an email to legislators alerting them to the numbers. Here's State Senator Joe Morrissey.
I think it was like they sent it to the legislators, look at what we're doing, because they knew you had the, you know, the spotlight on them. That's a good thing. I mean, it's a good thing for having spotlight on legislators and politicians and people that are responsible. Make them do their job.
According to the VEC, 8,756 fraudulent claims have been submitted to the agency to date. So far, they've paid out over $46 million in federal benefits and over $5 million in state benefits on fraudulent claims. Of that, the VEC has been able to recover about 44% of the state money, but just under 10% of the federal money.
They will get better, their auditors will get better, and people have to be prosecuted.
Morrissey, who represents Jacqueline Barber in the General Assembly, says,
my constituent, she did the right thing. She contacted, you know, folks. She contacted your station.
The VEC says they have a number of additional fraud investigations underway, and they expect numbers to grow.
You can't rob the bank, get caught, and say, okay, I'll give you the money back. There's got to be punishment. There's got to be consequences. If VEC does that, and the general, that's the area where the General Assembly would get involved to, you know, give the VEC a little more teeth to pursue recovery of fraudulently obtained monies.
So what should you do if you suspect unemployment fraud, and what steps is the VEC now taking to try to prevent fraud? That's all ahead at 11 o'clock. Working for you, I'm Melissa Hiplett for CBS 6.
Thank you, Melissa. And remember, if you're experiencing issues with unemployment benefits, we want to hear from you. Call us on the Problem Solvers line at 254-3672 or email problemsolvers@wtvr.com.